Andre Ward, smaller than Kovalev, like Pascal, he's coming up.
About my size.
Coming up from the...
Are you talking about as far as weight or mass or...
Just smaller in general. I mean, yeah.
Sergey's built like a cruiserweight. Yeah, maybe a small heavyweight.
He walks around as a cruiserweight. And,
yeah.
Right. So, who would you... Right now, who would you favor?
Right now it would be Sergey because of the activity. And the lack of activity of Andre Ward. I mean, out of fairness, you have to look at those things when you're at this level with a guy like Sergey, who's getting better, whose confidence is, you know, even if you're crazy enough to assume, I know, because of my experience, it's getting better every fight. He's getting better every fight. And so, in everywhere, we know he can punch. I mean, people know you can punch when he's 15-1. But the other little things that builds your legacy on being called in the great conversation, he's headed that way real fast. So when you look at that, and then you look at Andre Ward, who had a long distance of inactivity, that now he's back on track through Roc Nation. He now has been in position to get the fights that he won, sign a big HBO deal, and now fulfill that greatness that he has, I believe, that he has in him when it's all said and done. I'm just waiting to see, and it's not promoted by Golden Boy, anybody looking at this, but I'm telling you what I see and what I know, that he has a chance to beat anybody in the right circumstances of being ready that's in the division. But it won't be a cakewalk right now. Right now, it will be really bad management to throw him in there with a guy like Sergey right now because of activity. Not because of talent, it's because of lack of activity. They're getting prepared for mentally, and physically.
I mean,
too premature.
If you think about it, when is the last time that Andre Ward has actually been hit by small gloves? 2.5-3 years ago?
And you would put him in
2.5 years ago, and now you would put him in with we talked about this before, the biggest puncher pound for pound in boxing.
True.
Right? That probably, like you said, it's probably not a great decision.
you understand, I was in a ring with him. What city we are? Were we in New York? Where we at? New York?
Hit you so hard you don't even remember.
No, where are we at?
Madison Square Garden.
Okay. I know they changed the curtains.
No, hold on. No. Atlantic City. We're in Atlantic City.
Atlantic City?
Oh, no. Right now?
Oh, we're in Atlantic City?
We're in Montreal.
Oh, see, I played the head game on you.
I thought you meant...
Listen, we need to be... This is good footage. Please, don't. Listen, when a guy hits hard like a Sergey, and I'm not his promoter, I'm just giving props for props deserve that. He wasn't even in the ring with him, and he don't even know what the hell city he's in. He thinks it's a goddamn Atlantic City. You know, it's been shut down for a year. And he's a reporter, and he felt the rap. So you're gonna ask me, you know, I shouldn't know what city I'm in. And so I got an excuse. But back to the seriousness. Yes. He has to be one of the accurate and biggest puncher right now in the game of boxing. Absolutely.
Which is amazing that you got hit with a right hand, went down, was hurt, and finished that fight. That was, I mean, everybody ringside, you know, the consensus ringside, well, it's going to be a short fight, you know. John David Jackson told me last night, I thought, you know, it was always going to be over quick, you know, but you somehow cut through, and he got through that 12th round as well. It's amazing.
That's not trained. It's really not something that's born. It comes with the growing in character through the good and the bad times of young adolescence to young adult to a full adult or grown person. A lot of things you just can't teach. You know, and if you have that in you, the only way you know if you're really that guy is when you face that adversity. And every second and minute of that fight, I believed that I can still win it until the bell rung and the fight was over. When you have that mentality in any sport, yeah, reality got to come in, you're down 30, and it's the fourth quarter and it's 5 minutes to go. But in boxing, and not being dubbed as one of the biggest punchers ever in any age of my career, I always find a way to make those adjustments and find a way to somehow win. But I haven't been under them circumstances in a long time, fortunately for me. But when you go up against a guy that been trained by a guy that's been around me and been around other fighters and also was a champion himself, you gotta respect the teacher and you gotta respect the student. And when you have John David Jackson and the student, Sergey Kovalev, it's just like having Nazim Richardson and Bernard Hopkins. And so when you have those type of chemistry, which is very fruit in boxing, that's sincere, and really, because... Take a step back, you look at me, step back.